With the winds of war blowing in the Pacific, President Roosevelt uses his constitutional authority on July 26, 1941, and orders into service of the United States all of the organized military forces of the Philippines.
Everyone knows about Pearl Harbor on December 7, 1941, but perhaps lesser known is that within hours, Japanese forces also invaded the Philippines. 250,000 Filipinos answered President Roosevelt's call to duty.
Many enlisted knowing full well that the enemy could discover who they were and retaliate against their families.
These loyal and courageous soldiers fought bravely, sacrificed greatly, many even paying the ultimate price.
Every Filipino who went to the war was made to understand that we were fighting not only for our country, but also for the American people.
The 260,000 Filipino men and women who fought under the American flag were vital to the Allied victory.
Those brave men who promised citizenship and fair compensation bravely took up arms, who fought alongside American soldiers on the beaches of far-flung islands, who suffered the unspeakable brutality of Japanese POW camps, and died alongside American soldiers in the infamous Bataan Death March.
The casualties during this one-week march without food or water are staggering. Nearly 700 Americans and close to 10,000 Filipinos perish.
In resistance, they held aloft the spirit of a people for all the world to see, unbent, standing tall, enduring still.
MacArthur returns with the U.S. Armada in October 1944, and the combined forces of the U.S. troops and Filipino guerrillas quickly rout the Japanese.
In return for their valor and sacrifice, the American government promised them citizenship and the benefits entitled to all veterans. In 1946, however, Congress sadly, shamefully, reneged on this promise and refused to grant these veterans the citizenship and benefits they earned. But even in the face of such adversity, these veterans never gave up. They organized and fought for what they had earned. In 1990, after decades of advocacy, Congress finally fulfilled President Roosevelt's promise and awarded American citizenship to these veterans.
We honor them as an inseparable part of the fabric of our community and our country.
Let this ceremony serve to ensure that those who fought for freedom are never forgotten and are always remembered.
This is a story that needs to be told again and again so that our country does not forget.
I am Celestino Almeida, a 100-year-old veteran of World War II. As the saying goes, old soldiers never die. They just fade away.
I want my grandchildren and their grandchildren to know this story of courage and duty to country. Future generations must never forget why we are able to live our way of life today. We must always remember.